It's early. It's a new season. New chapter for EC Outdoors. We're going to kick off this year with a little bass fishing. We're going to introduce you to the one, the only, a new team member, Roy Robert, the deal doctor.
Morning.
He's a dealer for the people, folks.
That's right.
You heard it here first. You ready to go wake something up this morning?
Let's go.
Let's go. We'll see you on the lake.
Well, I love her, but I love the fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. And if I hit that fishing hole today, she'd be packing all her things and she'd be gone by noon. Well, I'm gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore, and I'm sitting in the sun. I'm sure it'll hit me when I walk through that door tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, I've got a bite. Oh, if I hurry, I could beg her to stay. That water's right and the weather's perfect. No telling what I might catch today. So I'm gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore, and I'm sitting in the sun. I'm sure it'll hit me when I walk through that door tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, another bite. Yeah, I'm gonna miss her. I've got a bite.
Two fish.
That's what we're looking for, something like that and a little bit bigger, I think. This fish has got these shoulders on it at least, rather than no shoulders. Get him in here for you guys. It's a little better fish, huh?
Oh yeah.
None of those little 15-inchers.
At least the otter didn't get that one.
That's about a probably 3-pounder, but nice fish.
Well, we had a very eventful morning. We had stayed up way too late the night before, but we got up anyway. We wanted to get after some bass. We did. It was a perfect morning, calm, foggy, beautiful morning. But we decided to take a break from the morning fishing, take a nap, get rejuvenated, and we wanted to get out that afternoon and get after some more fish, see how we did.
Thank you. we can only hope that Roy gets his thermocell working, otherwise it's gonna be a long night. Working now?
You hear that?
Oh yeah. Alright, no bugs now. Alright, fishing time. Each lake has its own colors that work better than others. On this lake, this particular lake here, it's usually like a black with a blue fleck, purple, June bug, and then my favorite, which is green pumpkin. And a couple years ago, I started doing it where I was always using like a 6-inch worm or 7-inch worm, and then I started going to a 10-inch worm. And ever since I started going to a 10-inch rubber tail, the amount of fish I caught almost doubled from the smaller worms. Now, I have a couple theories on why that is, but I can't be for sure. I think it just shows up better. There's more water displaced, causes more disturbance in the water. Fish seem to be a little bit bigger too, kind of weeded through some of the small ones. But whatever it was, it worked. Tonight should be a good night though. Roy's kind of put a little curse on us missing the first couple fish, but somebody's got to do it. Gotta know how to wriggle your worm though too. It's always key too. Don't know how to wriggle your worm, probably not gonna catch very much. So it's really a fact of life actually. It's a motto I live by. Little one, look at that guy. Eat him for supper. Where's the big dogs at? He didn't like that too much.
Might have to try out in deeper water. That's where they could be hiding.
So the plan for the evening was to get out early, fish for bass, see if we could get any lunkers, and then once it got more towards evening, we wanted to kind of switch it up and go for some big crappies, some big slabs. We got out there, did all right with the bass, and then came time for crappies. But just before we got to that point, my old man and his buddy came out and were going to fish with us, and my dad's pet decided to join us, if you wanted to call him a pet. It's kind of an odd pet, though.
This is how you call in snappers.
I'm back corner there.
You going my back? Oh, he is right here. Big old snapper.
What's going at him?
He's just swimming. He's coming up again. Here, give me that fish. Turn it around, he's going behind you. Well, watch your mini mite, he might suck that sucker in. Yeah, I see him. There, he's coming for it now.
See that white he's got there?
Yeah, I see that. I wonder if that's
blind one eye.
Get your hand out of there. Man, that grabbing your hand? Roy, stick your hand in there.
Damn, the head's as big as my fist.
I know he is. Grab my tail, are you gonna? Here he comes again. Trying to get the snapper to show you guys.
Well, you son of a... I'm going to tip the canoe over first. I'm gonna
hang on. He's dead. He's holding on for dear life on that fish, too.
better on the fish than me.
There he is. How much does that one weigh, Dad?
Probably 25.
He still got the fish.
And he still got the fish, and he's still eating it.
I'll get a hook out of him first. And I'll get a thing. He went back. He got the fish out, did he?
No, he don't.
Give it back, and I'll take it out of the hook. Kill him first and throw it to me.
A quarterback, Roy. Roy. Oh! Wait, he's dead. He's floating right there. Just hold him like that and see if he bites it.
There, you got your supper besides.
There he goes.
Wow.
Now it'll be like a dog. Every time we come out, it'll come over for a treat.
Oh,
there he goes.
It's coming up.
Yeah, Lord, you're already eating though.
I could take a little harassment strike. Like,
huh? Okay, we're gonna go. All right, we're gonna go back and fish after. Now he's done messing with us.
That's pretty cool.
Well, after all that excitement with Mr. Snapper, we're gonna get back to being serious. We're gonna regroup, and we're gonna hope to get some big crappies. The sun's down past the tree line. What we're doing is we're just using minnows and a jig and minnows and a size 6 hook and a split shot, fishing off the end of that tree there and this tree here, and hoping to catch a few. Got him?
Somebody say, hey, we want some crappies. Hey, we want some crappies.
Let me hear you say, hey, we want some crappies.
Hey, we want some crappies.
You guys say, hey, we want some crappies.
Hey, we want some crappies. Some crap.
You see, me and the fellas all have this dream, and that's to make the cover of Crappie magazine. So today we went up north and put the boat in the lake to catch some bass and crappie for criminy crape's sake. The Evan Rude was humming and we took a little ride so we could cast into the weed beds on the other side. Peeped through the anchor over as I rigged up my pole. About a 5-pound crappie's what I set for my goal.
Well, it's probably the last one we're gonna get on film tonight. As far as this, Roy's got a light. We could probably show you the fish, but mosquitoes are starting to get thick, and Roy took the thermosel. They're getting bigger.
Well, as you can see, it started getting dark on us. We're running out of camera light.
See how long we can last.
We did fish for about an hour and a half more, but the mosquitoes ran us off the lake. Thermosel didn't even do anything. They're like a bunch of overgrown. They look like a bunch of hummingbirds flying around us, let's put it that way. It was a successful day, even though we were dog tired. You can't beat a great day out on the lake in the middle of summer, especially those summer nights. So we hope you enjoyed this week's show, and we hope to see you next time.
I hung it on my scale to see what it counts. This one's the state record, 5 pounds, 1 ounce. Now that's the biggest crappie that I ever seen, and it got me on the cover of Crappie magazine.
Somebody say, hey, we want some crappie.